pray. Eternal God, our creator and redeemer, as you gladden the wedding at Cana in Galilee by the presence of your Son, so by his presence now bring your joy to this wedding. Look in favor upon Paul and Jane and grant that they, rejoicing in all of your gifts, may at length celebrate with Christ the marriage feast which has no end. Amen. Please be seated. We are gathered here this afternoon to celebrate the beginning of life's most fulfilling relationship. Marriage was ordained and designed by God our Father to reveal the depth and commitment of his love to us, his children. Paul and Jane have invited you here today to celebrate with them the commitment of their lives to one another and to the glory of God. This is a special time of worship, an active participation in the will of God for their lives. A wedding is a celebration of the highest that we know of love, the pledge of the deepest fidelity, the expression of the highest aspiration. It's an act of commitment to which Paul and Jane have given much thought and prayer. And today, Paul and Jane come before family and friends and God to affirm the choice that they have made of each other as life's partners. Paul and Jane, as you commit, as contemplate your vow to each other, realize that from this day forward, your lives will be woven of one design, and the perils and the joys that you will have will not be known apart. May you see in the relationship of Christ and the church the pattern of love and devotion that you will need to have towards one another so that Christ may truly be in your house. The Apostle Paul declared in 1 Corinthians 13 that love seeks not its own, it is patient, understanding, not easily provoked. Love does not gloat over the faults of the other, but affirms his or her good. Love is not judgmental, but forgives, and it believes all things. Paul and Jane, I charge and require you both, as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as the foundation of a happy, enduring home. No other ties are more tender. No other vows more sacred than these that you now assume. And if these vows be kept inviolate, and you steadfast endeavor to do the will of your Heavenly Father, then the home that you are now establishing will abide in peace. Paul, I require you to promise to love and to cherish Jane, to honor and sustain her, in sickness as in health, in poverty as in wealth, in the bad that may darken your days, and in the good that may light your way, and to be true to her in all things till death alone shall part you. Do you so promise? Jane, I require you to promise to love and to cherish Paul, to honor and sustain him, in sickness as in health, in poverty as in wealth, in the bad that may darken your days, and in the good that may light your way, and to be true to him in all things till death alone shall part you. Do you so promise? Who gives this woman in marriage? I ask you to join your right hands, and Paul, I'll ask you first of all to repeat after me. I, Paul Allen Tyson, take you, Jane Alexander Branyon, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, so long as we both shall live. Jane, will you repeat after me? I, Jane Alexander Branyon, take you, Paul Allen Tyson, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, so long as we both shall live. What token do you offer in pledge of your vow? time immemorial, the ring has been used to seal important covenants. The ring has no end and is therefore symbolic of the continuous commitment that these two now pledge to each other. It is a symbol for all who see it that your love and affection is given to a special person. Jane, will you receive this ring as a symbol of Paul's love for you and wear it as a symbol of your love for him? Paul, as you place this on her left hand, would you repeat after me? With this ring, I marry you. Everything in this world that is mine, I share with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Paul, will you receive this ring as a symbol of Jane's love for you and wear it as a symbol of her love for you? Jane, if you place this on his hand, would you repeat after me? With this ring, I marry you. Everything in this world that is mine, I share with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The instrumental piece that you're going to hear played in just a moment is entitled The Chaplain's Son. A couple of years ago, Paul was invited to compose a work that was dedicated to the war memorials in Washington, D.C. He remembered our family's visit to Washington, D.C. in the summer of 1984 and my visiting the Vietnam War Memorial and the emotional impact that it had on me. And with that in mind, he wrote this song that has been recorded by the prestigious London Philharmonic Orchestra. First of all, I would like to join, have prayer, and then you will hear this song played. Let us pray. Faithful Lord, source of love, pour down your grace upon Paul and Jane, that they may fulfill the vows they have made this day and reflect your steadfast love in their lifelong faithfulness to each other. As members with them of the body of Christ, use us to support their life together. And from your great store of strength, give them power and patience, affection and understanding, courage and love towards you, towards each other, towards the world, that they may continue together in mutual growth according to your will in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Thank you. as much as Paul and Jane have considered together according to the teachings of Scripture, and witnessed the same before God, their family and friends, and declared their love by the giving and receiving of a ring, by the authority that is vested in me as a minister of the gospel, I take great pleasure in pronouncing you husband and wife, but your name is Paul Allen Hyman. Therefore, what God hath joined together, let no man put it under. You may kiss your bride. Paul and Jane, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he turn his face towards you and give you peace. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Paul Allen Hyman.
I don't know. Well, I'm right now.
Thank you.
There you go. Talk to me, girls.
Get a drink.
Hello. Talk to me.
Hi. We love you, Jane and Paul.
Good.
But wait a little longer on the baby.
You can give her advice.
Wait a little while on the baby.
There you go.
About
5 years. Oh. I gotta get some shots before it gets too dark. All right, Jenny. How you doing? Good, good.
Come here, Paul.
All right. Jane can't get turned loose.
Thank you.
Jimmy, breathe in. Breathe in. Jimmy, breathe in.
One more. Okay. As many as I can get
in
the light.
I'm on back.
Okay, wait, one more.
Okay. No. Lord have mercy.
I'll show it to you in a minute when you get through.
What
was I doing? I don't know.
Fair. Let me show you something.
You want to give this to Jim Walker? You want to give this to Jim?
Good, I'll take that. I'll show y'all this. That's good.
Oh, have you got the sugar? Oh,
yeah.
Good. We're happy with you.
That's right.
We're very happy.
Come on, run. Run, you can't run fast.
I want to take a peek.
Wait a minute, I'll show you. Wait a minute. Look here. Look at that water face. Wait a minute. say.
I know how deep Paul's arm is. That's why I'm standing way back here. You guys are way, way too close.
No.
Okay, Paul, that's a clue.
You got to shoot it hard, Paul. Okay, go to it.
Jimmy Finley?
My kid with my
Jimmy Finley.
Go ahead.
Come on, Ron, get in the middle.
Woo! Woo! Yeah, go to it.